r/AskReddit. When was a time you smelled total bullshit and ended up being right? I'm an aspiring actor. I attended a presentation for 99 The Unagency, a company that represents itself as an alternative kind of talent representative for people with 9-5s. Everything felt off. Especially after they have this lengthy summary of all these roles they booked for their clients, which were mostly extra work. At some point the presenter said something like, "Of course, if this doesn't sound good to you, you can leave." Out of like 30 people, I was the only person who walked out. After doing some internet research, turns out they're essentially a scam that preys on would-be actors, charging to submit them to publicly available casting calls. They call themselves an unagency because they legally can't refer to themselves as agents. They also monitor Reddit for negative posts about them, so I assume this comment will get reported at some point. My grandfather was watching me and my sister over a few days because my dad had spinal surgery and my mom went to go stay with him in the hospital. At this time I was about 10. Anyways, my grandfather went out to get me and my sister some Sonic because we were all getting a bit hungry. He comes back with the food. And not 15 minutes later he tells us his wallet is empty. He asks us if either one of us got into his wallet. We both reply with, "No." Then he makes up an excuse and says that my mother had stolen it while he was asleep. She had left that day to go see my dad. I can obviously smell something fishy and he continues to tell us why he thinks his bullshit excuse is correct. He calls my mom and asks her why she stole his money. The truth was he actually went out and bought a shitload of alcohol, got drunk, and made an excuse as to why all his money had disappeared. Mom came back the next day, told him to get the fuck out of here and don't come back. Still despise that man to this day. Kid randomly started talking to me in uni for almost no reason. I was having smaller talk with him and I ended up telling him about a small business I have been running for about a year. He says he would like to start a partnership with me. I was immediately skeptical but still interested. We end up meeting up to talk about said partnership and it turned out he was trying to recruit me for a pyramid scheme. Kid handed me a booklet and told me to read it and get back to him. I must have asked him about 5 times what exactly it was that he did and he couldn't give me a straight answer. Come to find out, as previously stated, that I was just a subject of recruitment into their bullshit scheme upon research of the company he represented. I was at a market in Australia looking at these cheap counterfeit hats with American sports teams on them. As I was browsing, I heard the stall owner talking with a strange American-like accent. He said he was from Alabama. I'm from Georgia and whatever he had was not a southern accent. I'm 90% sure he was faking an American accent to match his fake hats. My ex-wife came home around 3 a.m. every night after closing at her new job, which closed to the public at midnight. I found it odd that it took 3 hours to close up a McDonald's. The store was nice, but that's a long time. For about 3-4 months this went on. She always went into great detail about work the next day. This was way out of character for her. I knew something was up. One night before she left, I had to use her car for something and my work phone fell out of my pocket. I searched everywhere for it. Now, I can access my location history through either my work or personal phones as they're linked, and at about 2 a.m. it hits me. I can just use the Google location history to find it. I found it alright. In her car outside of some dude's house where it had been since 12:15 a.m. Busted. I left her and upgraded. She downgraded like her MF. Lol, not even mad. A struggling student from my long-term subbing placement who desperately wanted to do well in school but had a very difficult time keeping on top of their work, understanding what they read. I wanted an evaluation. Admin told me it was too early in the year and to wait a few months. I knew something was wrong, but worked with the student and their family to keep them on top of their work to the best of my ability. Wouldn't you know, at the end of my placement, we got some news from the student's previous school. The student had been severely injured as a small child and may have a traumatic brain injury. This would, in turn, affect their organizational skills and some cognitive abilities. A formal evaluation was scheduled for after my placement ended. I knew something wasn't right. No one ever trusts a teacher's instincts. My cousin suddenly found a car Lego while mine was missing. I didn't think of it until my J from Lego Ninjago was gone and I was like HMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMMM I was 8, I think. A guy, M. 19 at the time, who I, F. 19 at the time, was, barely, dating, said his crazy ex who had ghosted him was trying to contact him again. I told him to just block her number. But he wouldn't. Turns out, his crazy ex was his mentally challenged 14-year-old cousin who he would get blowjobs from, while promising to marry her someday. She was upset when she saw online that he had a girlfriend. My heart aches for that girl every day. And I dumped him like the shitbag he was. A friend was telling me about this deal he found online. I told him it was probably a scam. He said it wasn't. A week later, he came back to me complaining about getting scammed. When I saw the Cyberpunk release date, a teacher from high school creeped me out. Everyone loved him. But I smelled BS the moment I met him. Turns out he was sleeping with a student and was fired soon after that. I told my boss that my paychecks weren't accurate and she said I wasn't calculating my taxes right. I told her I know that I was. I looked up my pay stubs online and found she was skimming about 4 hours of time off my check every week. Earlier today we had a tornado warning and my mom said to me open the window by the door. I ask why. Because it helps keep the tornado from tearing apart the house. I immediately turned around and said that's the stupidest thing I've ever heard and she had to stop and think about it since she couldn't come up with any reason as to why it'd help. Turns out she was told that as a kid 50 some odd years ago and hadn't questioned it since. I was playing Secret Hitler with my buddies last night and I guessed the two fascists from the get-go. Couldn't fool this guy. Applied for a job at Vector Marketing when I was desperate. Total pyramid scheme. Grew up in a cult. Jehovah's Witnesses. Smelled the bullshit around the time I was 18. At that point I was already baptized. About 2 years ago, age 25, I ended up being right about it being a cult. Big problem is, when I decide to leave, I lose my whole family and all my current friends. Growing up in a cult sucks. My friend's on again. Off again boyfriend left her for good because he got a girl pregnant during their last off again spell. He ended things saying he needed to grow up and be there for this girl and his unborn child. My friend announced she was also pregnant with his child a few short days later. And put this dude through hell. I started thinking she was lying pretty early on in the pregnancy. She eventually convinces him to leave the girl. To be with her and their child. She conveniently had a miscarriage few weeks later. I confront her and tell her that either she tells the guy the truth. Or I will. She acknowledged the lie but refused to tell the guy. So I told him. I stopped being her friend. He left her ass. And ended up very happily married with the other girl. Nurses deny taking medicine from patients. Nurses denied selling medicine taken from patients. Well, the labs told a different story. Some nurses at the VA in my state were caught using cannabinoids that were meant for the patients they were in charge of caring for. The urine drug analysis revealed negative results for the elderly patients, but positive for THC and other derivatives in the nurses. This happened in grade 5 at my Catholic school. My friend who I'm just gonna call David lost his gel pens which were really popular at the time and everyone borrowed some from him. One time he left his desk for a few minutes and his gel pens were taken. I sat close to his desk but I didn't see anything. Nonetheless he told the teacher and the teacher got everyone to check their desks. After I was done I looked over to this girl, I'll just call her bitch since she was always one, and she opened her tray under her desk for 1 second then fucking closed it straight away. Then she said she checked, I smelt bullshit. I told David about it and then we checked her desk as she got up for the bathroom and what did we found? We found the motherfucking gel pens. We told the teacher straight away and bitch went to the principal's office. She's stolen a lot more after this. I do kapa haka, which is a traditional Maori performing arts. In the practices we have to do a lot of fitness and moving around so we can sing and dance at the same time. We have trainings on the Fridays. So at training, this girl walks in with a bad ankle. As soon as I saw her limping, I knew it was bullshit. She just didn't want to do the exercises or anything in that matter. She got caught out the next day for faking an injury and got cut from the team. My tutors are very strict and don't put with stunts like that. My mum's ex. Met him the first time when I was like 10. And didn't like him. 7-8 years later, his abusive behavior escalated. My mum ended up in hospital and I was nearly shot because he lost his temper one night. Haven't seen him since. Thank fuck. But it took my mum about a year to leave him for good. My mother and brother lie about everything. If they are talking, they are lying. I am always right about it. When my Tinder match told me to verify my profile and it asked for my credit card info. You aren't adopted. You're our son. Comma. New VP of sales marketing at a former employer smelled like BS when I first met him. Proved to be a total douche in the ensuing months. After 21 years with the company, I walked in one day and quit. I went on to bigger and better things and am now very happily retired since age 62. His wife left him after many years of marriage. Took half of his retirement money, so he and the people left working for him are stuck there until he reaches 70. Maybe more. We have no plans for a layoff. At this time. Yeah. That means to wait 2-4 weeks for the announcement. But you're my best friend. They had like 30 other people who they said this to. I got paid my expense claim early. Company had poor cash flow and never paid anything early. Rat was smelled. Suddenly something clicked. I went through the mail, it was a while ago, and by lunchtime me and business partner had worked out 6 different fraudulent methods used by our accounts person to siphon money off us. It explained the bad cash flow. We thought it was just growth. Directly led to us shedding all the staff, and it's just been the two of us for 20 plus years since. Jussie Smollett. But so did everyone else. The minute I saw the hate mail he allegedly gotten. The letters and drawing were comically cliche. Like something out of a 90s movie. My friend's now ex-GF is a sociopathic. Pathological liar. And she lies about every fucking thing. Still amazed how he could tolerate her for 3 years and not see through her lies. Edit. Smelled that BS on the first time I met her. I drove past a farm. Thought I smelled manure. I was right. My brother said the dog drew on the wall when I was 11. It took my a year, but I gathered evidence and busted his lying ass. Ex told me she wanted an open relationship, but my first instinct was she had cheated on me, and eventually she admitted to sleeping with her weed dealer the night before at a party. What made it worse was he was going to the same music festival as us the next week, so I'm assuming she would have slept with him then and tried to make it seem okay because of the open relationship. SMH. Toxic. When I read A Million Little Pieces, I remember telling my sister that this James Free guy was totally full of shit based on his descriptions of therapy and the inauthentic dialogue. None of it rang true. And it really ticked me off that this asshole would misrepresent therapy and rehabilitation so blatantly, all in an effort to make himself look more enlightened or something. He continues to publish terrible books and abuse every MFA student foolish enough to work with him. He has them write boilerplate yes sci-fi novels and then puts his own name on the cover. I really hate that guy. There was some public outcry about a Muslim girl being assaulted and harassed by a Chinese guy in Toronto. It even got addressed by the PM. I smelled bullshit and said the story didn't make sense. Got promptly downvoted, which is the MO on the Toronto subreddit anyway. Sure as shit, a few days later the girl admitted it was a hoax. Every time I get a whiff of a person who uses essential oils. Ex-girlfriend told me she believed she was pregnant about 2 weeks after we split. She has an IUD. So I knew it was a little fishy. Ended up taking her to the gynecologist to get tests done. And a few days after told me she got a call. And said she was pregnant. She then tells me she told her gyno she was going to have an abortion. And her gyno told her to take a plan B. Eat pineapple and cinnamon. And she will miscarry the baby. Ex-girlfriend does this. Claim to miscarry child. And try to guilt me into coming back with her to take care of her since she was an emotional wreck after losing a child. All of this was bullshit. She actually got a call and sent me the voicemail, and it says she was all clear. This went on for about a month. She trapped me and emotionally and mentally abused me. In the first year of our relationship, my now wife was always suspiciously vague whenever Breaking Bad came up. She always said the same higher level talking points and nodded vigorously when people would talk about plot points, but never really contributed to the conversation. I called her out eventually as having never seen the show, and she turned beet red and admitted she'd never seen it, but that I wasn't allowed to tell anyone because she was so sick of having people say, "Oh my god, you have to watch it. It's so good. I can't believe you haven't seen it." TLDR, my wife is a liar, liar pants on fire. I was friends with a pathological liar when I was really young, ages 5 to 14. I knew pretty much everything about her. She told all the other kids that she had an older brother. That her dad died in a volcano. That her mum fostered kids. She had a horse in her backyard and so many other things. I smelled bullshit on all of it cause I literally knew none of it was real. She only has sister. Her dad was stabbed to death in their driveway by druggie. Her mum absolutely did not foster kids cause I went to her house literally every other day. There wasn't a fucking horse in her backyard cause there was no backyard. Everyone believed her bullshit but me and my twin. I even told one of my friends that she was a liar when they became friends, and I became the bad guy for it. A few years down the line and my friend tells me that she a liar. Like no shit. Really? Every February the company wouldn't pay us complete wages because February isn't a full month. No amount of arguing would change the payroll lady's mind. When I left the company I went through DWP. And they claimed back all my missing money for each February that I worked there. Fucking idiot. That lady was Teresa. You moron. Freeze mold. The reason why my and my sister's Valentine's Day candy that our father got us went missing. Well, now ex friend claimed to the guy who just broke up with her that she was pregnant. Another friend and I told him it was bullshit. She's just trying to get you to stay with her. Sure enough. Her stories to all three of us weren't adding up. And soon after she lost the baby. My friend was telling me about her favorite teacher. Who was so cool and really chill. She told me about how he had her friend who was struggling with family problems and mental illness making her vulnerable on Snapchat, and immediately alarm bells went off, but she was sure that it was all good. I was going to report it, but the next day he was arrested for child porn and having sex with a minor. Matched with some students on Tinder and had at least 14 female students on Snapchat. But yay. What a guy. Edit. Most upvoted comment ever for me. Thanks everyone. My then boyfriend's friend claimed she had brain cancer. After a year of dating I got really suspicious. She was managing her cancer with only weed and benzos. She'd fall or have a seizure and would ask my boyfriend to come help her. I also never met her. Which I thought was strange. Since she was my BF's best friend. One day BF calls me up and says best friend just told me she doesn't actually have cancer. Least surprising thing I've ever heard. But you shouldn't really accuse someone of faking cancer. He stayed friends with her. We hired this guy who was talking about how he was this great engineer in Brazil. I used to live there. And he would pronounce all the Brazilian cities the way you would in Spanish. Which is super suspicious, lispy s. Turns out he was a con artist. And had jobs at multiple companies which he all lost. If you want to get nothing in return, you can like and join my Discord. There is a link in the description.